Jimmy K here, Metal Voice. Look at this. The Metal Voice shirts are now on sale. Just go to the video description to find out on how you can purchase one. Metal!
Welcome to the Metal Voice, a special edition. A special edition. You know, we've come, in a sense, full circle. We had an interview in December. You told me about your illness. This is Lee Kerslake, by the way, former Uriah Heep, former Ozzy Osbourne drummer. We had an interview we did in December. It went viral. It went viral. It went everywhere. You wrote a letter to Ozzy Osbourne. We did an interview. The interview went everywhere.
Oh, that's good. That's
and
cool.
Now, here you are in California at the Hall of Heavy Metal History. So just tell me about getting here, the trip here.
Well, basically, I was at home back in England, and I was just actually trying to get my dog to realize who I'm his master, and I love him as a bitch. My dog ignores me, there's no tomorrow. He's my wife's dog. Anyway, I've been working on it. And then the phone rang. Hello? Oh, this is Pat Gosuardo. And I said, oh, yeah. And he didn't mention who he was and what he was doing. He said, you've been inducted into the Hall of History for metal. And I went, well, that's great. He said, we'd love to have you over here. And I said, well, basically, my friend, I said, I can't afford it. I mean, I'm on a pension. And situations aren't the same when you know you're retired. And I said, I just can't do it. And he said, well, what if we take care of it for you? I said, well, without sounding like a diva, I can't travel economy because I have psoriatic arthritis and bone cancer now. And it's like it plays havoc with my bone and my spine. And he said, well, we're going to fly you first class. And I nearly broke down and cried. And I just went, nah. What a lovely thing to do. And the next minute he said, yeah, not only that, we're going to present you with this presentation of an award because what you've done with Randy Rhoads and Ozzy and Bob Daisley. And we can only tell you that there's so many people out there want to see you and hear from you. And I said, oh, I'd love to come. And I said, okay, and I prepared myself. I had to make sure I got really straight and healthy because, as you know, cancer and things as such, they don't mess around with you. They say, here, I'm here, mother. Bang. And you get this. Anyway, I'm handling it, I'm fighting it. And I got myself all clean and together and got it organized and got permissions from the doctor, and then they were just absolutely. In Guy's Hospital Cancer Ward, the consultants that take care of me, there's four major ones, and they were absolutely gnarled. They thought, great, brilliant, and go. So I had the okay, and I was on my way. And I got here after 10 hours, and I got landed on that, and I just went, I made it. I haven't done this for 22 years.
I just find it amazing how, you know, you told me that like music cures, right? How much has it helped you in the sense like, so you're fighting bone cancer, you're fighting
psoriatic arthritis. Do you sleep apnea?
Yeah.
Do you diabetes? Yeah. And double heart murmur? And I find it all, but I'm on top of it. And without a shadow of doubt, and I swear, honestly, music's kept me going. With my love of it, I miss it like crazy when I'm not on stage, but my love of it has kept me going. And the thought of being able to do it the odd occasion. I mean, I've got to the point where I was on chemo. And I don't know, you know, chemo's not very, very uncomfortable.
Yeah, very uncomfortable, yeah.
And I was quite sick with it, but I still determined. I went in, and I got into a studio with a very close friend of mine called Jake Liberetto, who's a genius guitarist. I mean, wow, guitarist.
Yeah.
And I don't say that lightly. He's up with Randy Rhoads, Mick Box, Zach, you know, them. And he came in, and we... we did not start doing the album. Although I was always wanted to do this, my solo album.
Do you have a copy of it?
I have it.
Is
with
that
me.
There? No.
I have it in my case.
We're gonna grab it later. We're gonna show it.
Okay. Yes, it's a mix. I've done the mixing. I've not got the cover finished. I've just written in the songs.
Right. So we won't show it yet.
But you got it's called 11-teen.
Yes.
And it's got this, and I'm on the front cover in my old favorite Harley Davidson cap, which is 1953. Yeah. And my dog who passed away last year under my arm. And it's just, the reason I called it 11-teen is because when I was a kid at school, I loved maths. I was an absolute brain dork mathematician, you know, nerd. And I went to the school, the maths teacher, and I said, you know, why isn't it 11-teen? He said, well, it's silly. I said, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 11, 20. What's wrong with that? And he looked at me as if I was nuts. And so I went, okay, one day I'll use it. And that's
the day.
That's why I'm doing it.
All right, so on an even happier note. So we did an interview in December, right? Pat calls you up even before to induct you. Then Pat calls you to tell you, we're going to fly you in so you could be here live. Then, hold on a second, you finally get your bucket list completed, at least number one. Number two is be here. But number one was to get the platinum disc from Ozzy and Sharon Osbourne. So what was your reaction when you got these discs and a letter?
Oh, yeah. Well, the reason all that came about was I've been sick. I've been given a year to live, and I'm battling my way through it. And that's where it is. And I got a manager and friend, and he's Steve. He said, I'll get in touch with Sharon's publishing company because I just would wish that they would give me a couple of those platinums that I deserve, so that I could go, and when I'm sleeping, I could put them on my wall, and just as I see, I go, yeah, I did them.
Yeah.
Sleep well. You know, I'm not saying if I fell asleep, never woke up, I'm just saying that's what I would love to do.
But what was your first, like, you got the call, they're coming.
Well, I didn't know.
You didn't know?
No.
I mean, what happened?
I knew nothing about it.
Ding dong on the door, was that it?
No, my manager came round because we were filming me packing because I've got a documentary about starting. Well, by Taylor Goodman. And they were filming me. And my manager came and he said, I got a surprise for you. And he brought in these two big boxes. And I went, what? He undid them and they were there. Prior to this, I sent a very warm-hearted, honest letter written by hand to Ozzy to say, look, they've given me a few months to live, and on my bucket list, I would love to have these two albums. I'm not asking for a whole lot. There's about 17 I'm giving to understand, but just to make, let me know that they're there. And he sent me back a beautiful letter, handwritten, to say, yes, no worries. And Sharon had them done, and they were there. And I was...
Was it a crying moment?
Oh!
Was it a crying moment? I feel like crying just you telling me the story.
I flood the Thames. I mean, I was so... to be so late, but still realised that I did something that I'm happy with and honest with, and Sharon became very honest. That's why we buried the hatchet.
Yeah.
I respect her, and I think I love him a bit, Ozzy, and they sent me a lot of texts saying good luck.
Beautiful.
And stay healthy. Hey, I can't complain of that.
And we spoke on the phone. You told me you just went to the doctor. Is it stable, the cancer now? What's going on?
It's come back, unfortunately. It's come back with a vengeance, but. I'm not worried about it at the moment. I'm too much enjoying this moment for myself.
And you should.
Yeah, and I'm having a great time. one thing I've got to do is they turned around and said to me, oh, you know, I had the checkup done when I was before I left to make sure everything's kosher. And they said, oh, by the way, when you get back, we're going to put you on a new drug. Enzalutamide or what? Or, anyways, everything that ends in a Z
is
a drug for cancer. And I said, okay. I said, all right. And okay, yeah, I'll go with that. This is very expensive. I went, oh, goody. I'm up with the rich people's up because they're doing it for nothing for me. Yeah. But they, you know, the wonderful thing is the consultant said is, we think so much of you. You're such a lovely guy, and we like you so much. We're working day and night to try and get you back down and getting things sorted out for you. Yeah. And that is, you know, to me, that's saying, well, I must be doing something right when your consultants who get thousands of people with cancer every, you know, week come in there. Yeah. I said that to me. I just said, I'm a lucky guy. I'm a lucky person.
Well, you're lucky because tonight at the Hall of Heavy Metal History, they will be presenting to your awards. It would be filmed tonight for your documentary.
Yeah, that's
it's going to be beautiful because in front of a lot of people. I mean, you opened it up in your home, right?
Yeah.
But there wasn't an audience. This time around, there's going to be an audience, and they're all going to witness you holding up those plaques.
Yeah.
Well, that's some great film right there.
This is how skinny I am. See these new trousers?
Beautiful.
They're long. They're so long because I put on weight because of my steroids. I phoned downstairs. I said, "You got any needle and cotton?" And, oh yeah, we have, sir. I said, "Have you got someone that can sew?" Why? I've got to get these hemmed. No, we don't do that, sir. We don't do that, sir. So I'm going to be sat here.
We're going to leave it on this note. Thank you, Lee, for being on the show.
Yes, I want to thank you and thank everybody for having the faith in me and getting me here. I appreciate it, and I love you all, and God bless.
All right, so, yeah, this is very special. This is a very long time in the making for Lee Kirsten, and, you know, I am so honored to play a pivotal role in this. You know, this is something that Lee has waited for his whole life. And the whole thing really started, as many of you know, as the world knows, with our good friend over here, Jim Kay. And it all started with an interview on the Metal Voice with Jim. And when Lee had told the world of a certain issue, of health issues, I felt compelled to do something about this. I know one of his bucket list items was to get the gold and platinum albums, and the platinum albums from Sharon and Ozzy Osbourne. So after Jimmy's interview, I decided to try to take matters into my own hands for Lee. Lee, you're awesome, and I'm a big fan, my friend. And so I knew how long it was to make it, 38 years. So I put some things in motion, and Sharon and Ozzy, we had a conversation, and they were so gracious in order to make this move forward for our dear friend Lee. And Lee, why don't you come on? Here he is.
Yes!
Very special thing. This is from Ozzy directly. There it is. So it says, Lee, I really hope you enjoy the discs. It seems such a long time since I've seen you. It must be at least 35 years or more. My, how time flies when you're having fun. I'm so happy. I'm so sorry to hear that you're not doing so well with your health right now. I myself am getting ready to go on tour. Yet again, it seems years that it stops, but again, it's what we do for our life. Anyway, God bless and stay safe. Always awesome. So, Lee, congratulations, my friend. Here you go.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I got a few people I want to thank here.
So, I might be a bit of time, I'm sorry. But anyway, I've got to thank Pat, who's treating me like a god, and I don't deserve that. I'm just so proud to be here and receive this honor, especially these two as well. Pat's been treating me so well, looked after me. And Eddie, he's been great. Ace, bless you. Adam, bless you. Everybody who's involved with it, have looked after me. And Trenny, you're fabulous. And all I want to say is, long live rock and roll. Thank you. God bless you all. God bless. Hey, it's Christmas.
We love you, Lee.
I love you too. Oh, that sounded like Michael Jackson, didn't it?
All right.
This is a great honor, you know. I know they say it's things come when you wait and be patient. And I'm not a patient man, so I'm very impatient at times. But this was worth every year of wait to get this and those records. It does pay to be patient, and it ends up in your favor. So, once again, thank you ever so much for listening to this video.
And you need carpet.
Bless you.